Alright guys, this end has to be, this is where the aqua cube is. I have to push this up to the ceiling, strap it in, and then I should have enough clearance, hopefully, for the flex line to plug right in there. This side I got mounted already, just with the one strap for now. And I had to jump up on the ladder and hold everything up. And it ends right there, a couple feet below the manifold, so that won't be too bad to pipe in. I can either grab another flex line or just do it in copper, whatever. But for now, I'm going to jump up on here and see if I can get some stuff done. I don't know if you'll be able to see me on camera while I do this, but it's going to be fun. Now, where's my, I gotta find a strap. I also have to turn the 90 a bit as well. So, let me kind of get organized. Nice thing is, now I got a table up here to work on, work with. My ladder. I did take my composting toilet vent off. I still don't smell anything. So obviously that's working fine. So I'm gonna jump up here and hopefully you guys can see what the hell I'm doing. Yeah, definitely need to turn that. I gotta turn it this way. Well, that was easy. Okay. This pipe is going to be too long. And I am off the wall. I'm short. So, I can build it up with a block. Or, I might have to build it up with a block. That's gonna look pretty ugly though. Let me see. What can I do? Let me grab a piece of 2x4 and see what are my options. So just a minute here. Dig out a 2x4. Couple scrap 2x4s from the build. We'll see if I can do a little something. Oh man, it still needs a third. I'll have to go like this. Whoops. Instead of 2x4s, I think I can use I'm going to use some strapping. Hopefully I have some in here. If not, I'll grab some out of the truck. See what we got here. Doesn't look like I have any here. I'm going to go jump in the truck and see if I got any in there, guys. I'll be back. All right, I got some strapping right here. I think I'm going to use that instead. Wrap around this really well. I don't need these wrenches up here now. One-inch screws. This will be kind of crazy. So, I'm going to put two screws in this guy. Go as tall as I can, actually. Now, gotta lift this up, wrap it around tight. Hold it up with my head, possibly. Whoops. That's not good. Split the wood a little bit. Okay. Hopefully you guys can see this and not just me up on the ladder. Okay, so that's not bad. Now, I'll probably put another one right here. First things first, I gotta pull everything off the table, see if the aqua cube will be okay like this. I'm going to probably have to do some adjusting, big time. So I'll put all this down here. Okay, pipe wrench. Don't need those. So, aqua cube. So obviously the pipe is too long. What I can do though is have it go over top of this and be more comfortable. And then I'll have to go under my water pipe. Pump, and then I will dope this up, and that should work. Okay, so let me dope things up here, guys, and I will grab the dope, and we'll do this. Might have to move this. I'll have to do that later on, I guess. So, hopefully I'm not all screwed up in the camera here. Okay, looks good. Take that piece, grab an adjustable, and go to town. Flex piece. Oh, grab my adjustable. I think it's over here. And hopefully things will work out. Hopefully it doesn't. If it does twist, it'll be tightening it, so it won't be a big deal. Well, maybe it is good. A good thing I got a shorter flex hoses. Because this guy's... And all this gas pipe is just scrap, guys. Didn't pay for it. So, that's kind of a bonus. The only thing I paid for was $35 for the two flexes. And that's about it. Oh, man. All right. That guy's on there. So, I'm going to definitely need to put another strap back here because that's too wobbly for my liking. I can actually straighten that up now instead of putting that kink in it that I did. Tighten that, wing that back up. Okay. I think I tightened this one, I'll double check. Yeah, that's tight. Okay, so this one has to be tightened. Don't need very much tightening. Okay, so I'm gonna put another strap on here right now. That will be fine, and then I'll put one over here at the other pipe. So I'll be back once I have that stuff strapped up. All right, guys, the cold weather is starting to affect the battery and it's getting low. I got the warning on here. So I put another strap in here, closer to the joint, and then I just have that one. This is still, it's got a little bit of play still. What I might do is, it's not bad though. It's not like it's going anywhere. It's just got a little bit of movement. This one is, there's one there, and one down here. I had to move my fire extinguisher because it was right here in the way. And I still have enough space behind it to attach to it and feed it down to the manifold right here. And I gotta select either that one or that one where that's gonna be connecting into. And this is the supply for the whole thing that's coming off the propane. And everything's got shutoffs. And this one is a shutoff to the fireplace. And so basically I have a spare, just in case I get a propane cook stove or something later on. No big deal. I can pipe that later when the time comes if I do need that. So, I hate these tags. I'm going to leave them on because I think you're supposed to. It says right on them. It's kind of a pain. Other than that, it should be fine. I'm going to leak check everything though once we get all hooked up and running. I got a lot of leak checking to do. Once we have the manifold in, everything plumbed, leak check the entire manifold, leak check all my joints. I'll leak check around the regulator for the aqua cube, because I have been moving it around and it's been all over the place. But this thing's pretty solid. It's not going anywhere. Like, it goes right back to position when I hit it. It's got a little wiggle, but this side is pretty much locked down. I don't think we're gonna have too many issues. And this thing won't be full of gas when it's on the road, because I will shut that off and purge the lines, because that would be a no-no, having that kind of stuff going on. So now I guess this is the official spot where the aqua cube's going to go. I do have lots of room up in front of it still. Maybe I can put some soaps and stuff here, or another planter near the window. And then there's the control for that. And obviously this is the shower plug, lots of hose to plug into there. No big deal. I don't have them plugged in because I'm just letting the moisture get out of all the lines and system. I will have to take this apart, the fireplace, and do another video. Add a longer nipple to make it over to, there's where we're coming down with the gas. So the manifold's going to be sitting in right about here, just behind the toilet, off to the right of the toilet. And I'm going to have to add an extension on here to make that connection. So that's about it. Yeah, that's it for today, guys. I'm going to put all the compost stuff back on. So this just fits on here. And this just plugs into here. Nothing's glued. So I can remove it later and so forth. I haven't needed to empty the toilet yet because it's not even that full. The wonders of composting. So, check out the plants, how they survived the cold. I think they did not too bad. Still lots of moisture in there. You can hear it squishy. I'm gonna clone two more plants to add to this planter, I think, because why not? The other one took off really well, so why wouldn't I? So I got a lot of cleaning up to do now that I did a bunch of construction work in here. This guy's unreal. This planter's on the south side of the trailer. There is the sun behind some clouds. And this guy is unbelievable. Look at the roots in there, guys. You guys see that? All the way. This thing took off huge. So the stones, the paper as a wick. I haven't had to water this guy, either of them, because the moisture is just holding in there for such a long time. This is like bombshell idea. Any moisture, all the water, gravity drains to the bottom of the thing. But remember, I layered both sides with paper towel. So the paper towel, the water absorbs, or the paper towel absorbs the water. The water is pulled back up and wicks up to about just below the top area of the soil here. So, and then anything, and then I have the rocks and stones, the stones inside there. Hopefully you guys can see that. And that takes care of some evaporation. So I really don't have to worry about this guy too much. Now these spots where the tips are dead like that, I give them a little rip and they pop off, and I just shove that back inside the container. But I'm gonna leave the windows open still, guys. We're down to it is 1 o'clock now, quarter after one. 61% humidity in here. I think we're reaching the lowest it's been. So I don't think I'm going to need to burn off anything. One more night, we should be the same as outside humidity. And that will be nice. Save some money, all that good stuff. So I'm going to clean up, guys. I got a bunch of crap in here now to clean up. I got to prepare for Mike's arrival. He's going to have a nice visit here and get the big tour. And so far, so good. So, gas piping the tiny house. Success, I would say. I still have to finish it off, though. Manifold connections to the fireplace in there. And then I'm going to grab a propane cylinder, just a regular size one, not my big ones. Fill it up. Open it up. Then I can leak check the entire system just off that propane tank, which is going to be awesome. And then I'll run the fireplace and the shower. Who knows? Test everything out. Might as well. So, yeah, that's it for now, guys. At the off-grid tiny house, a lot of work being done now. Winter is coming, though. It is October the 1st in this video. And, oh man, it's starting to get bitter. I haven't taken my jacket off, by the way. But, whatever. I gotta clean up. And next video, I'll probably be finishing up the gas. And we'll go from there. Thanks for watching. One more little update, guys. I relocated the fire extinguisher in between the pantry and the aqua cube in this space here for maybe future washing machine, possibly. Because it was the fire extinguisher was originally there near the fireplace, which I didn't like anyway. But so we got one here and one near the door, right there. So you can see them. It's above the pantry, so you can spot them easily. In case it's not me who has to put the fire out, and good to go. So that's it. Little update.